I've been here for now quite some time, I think. And I want to really tell you something important. That Los Angeles is a very, very important area. And compared to all other counties and states, Los Angeles has not taken such a big stride the way it started. And especially when I had a program here, very few people came in after that. What is the reason for that? I tried to find out. First of all, you must realize your own personal responsibility that you all have got Surge Yoga absolutely free, but you have a certain debt. And that debt is that you have to give realizations to others. If you just have it for yourself and leave only to your leaders to work it out, it will never work. How many people have you given realization? You have to count it. Because after a certain state of your achievement, you become very creative, extremely creative. At this age also, I am working. But what I find, once you get your realization, you are settled down with yourself and you become like a monk. We don't want to have monks and priests. What do we want to have? Surge Yogis who will talk about Surge Yoga to people, who will develop Surge Yoga and create more Surge Yogis. So you have to count how many Surge Yogis you have created. Yesterday you saw Kanand. Anand is of course my grandson, but the way he got his realization. I find him every day he tries to find somebody if he could give realization. Every day. Yesterday again he brought two people. So you see, he says, you don't have to feel shy about it. I have seen people who have false gurus. Once I was traveling with some lady, she was very hot. So I asked her, what's the matter? How are you? Who is your guru? She told me the name. Horribly, horrible guru. Oh my God, she says, so great, he's done this, he's done that. And I was amazed how he's talking so much about that guru, but Surge Yogis feel shy, they don't want to tell. There's nothing to feel shy. If you have got realization, it's the greatest thing you have got. I mean, you don't understand the value of it perhaps. And you don't want to also talk about it to others, like you want to preserve it to yourself, I don't know why. But you have to talk to other people. Otherwise, Surge Yoga won't spread in Los Angeles. Or I should say California on the whole. Now the reason is, also I personally think, that you not only feel shy, but you are quite satisfied with yourself. And you have no confidence about others. You think, what will they think? What will they think after? What will they do to you? What will happen to them? I mean, if you tell them, they are not going to prosecute you, take you to courts. But I find this very much here, I don't know why, in Los Angeles. And at the same time, we have very deep Surge Yogis here. Very, very deep. They have achieved quite a lot, but for what? It's like a miserly person who has lots of money, good for nothing. This is one of the reasons you all have to decide. It's your personal responsibility, your debt to the Divine. It looks after you. It protects you. It helps you. So many of you can say how it has protected you, how it has helped you, how it has cured you. In every way it has done so much for you. Now what have you done for Surge Yoga? One has to see to it, introspect, find out. Another thing from organizational point of view, I've talked to Dev and others also, that first you should try to concentrate on one center. Now you divide among yourselves, all of you should decide that 50% people will go on Saturday, 50% will definitely go on Sunday. You see, there are more new people than the Sahajogis. When I found out, I was surprised, what are they up to? It's a Saturday and Sunday. This is your job. This is everything you have to do. Otherwise, what's the use of your life as a divine personality? I just don't understand.
Mommy.
How such deep people in Sahaja Yoga cannot feel that others are lacking this depth and they need joy. They need everything that you have got. And you have to do it. So on superficial things, if you waste your energy, it's not doing any justice to Sahaja Yoga. Los Angeles is one of the first places I came to. And at that time here, there was this 16-year-old guru who was befooling everyone. And I just felt, these are stupid people, I don't know. What will I do here? So I didn't come for 9 years. So you have to take to Sahaja Yoga in a proper way. In your family, with your children, with everything. Now there has been something they wrote in internet. I think it's a very poisonous thing. Because it has no meaning. It's all absurd. Now we have got the answer written down. We are not sending it yet. But you all should know it so you can answer it. At this age also, you see, I'm so anxious that I have to complete my projects, which are 36 in number. So far we have gone, maybe 37. And we have to complete this, all this, for which I'm not asking your help or anything. But it's very important projects we have got. Some are in India, which I started earlier, and then some are in England, some are here, some are in Canada, like that. What I'm saying, that you too should have projects about Sahaja Yoga. But at the same time, I would like to warn about something. Like you sent some book on this thing. First of all, Hirsch is never to be dependent. I don't know why you take him so seriously. Do you know he brought some horrible medicine to sell in Kabela? No, don't know. He brought it, Chinese. And he sold it for a very high price there to all the Sahaja Yogis. But Gregor's tongue became absolutely green. So imagine, nobody has business to sell anything without asking. So you see, one should not have anything to do with it. Then also I saw the book, but you should not write any book like that. You see, this book is not to be given to anyone. Those who want to cure people, they should cure, but it's not important. That's not your duty. If you want, you can cure. But it's not your duty. Main duty is to give realization to people. So that book is to be cancelled completely, out of question. Such a book should not be written because I have to spend some time reading it and all that. But there's no need to write such a book. First take my permission. If I say yes, write it. Otherwise, without writing me, if you write a book, I can't understand. And then you send it to me to read it. It's wrong. First you ask me. All right, you ask me the contents, you ask me if you don't want to write like this. But otherwise my time is so limited in that you want me to read the book, this thing. These are all small, small things. Now, smallest thing is writing letters. All the time writing letters to me. There are so many letters like that. Now, in that letter what do you write? You never write how many people you have given realization. No one. They will write, my husband is not all right, my wife is not all right, and we are having a fight, this and that, and that and that. It's not important. Now you have become Sahaja Yogis, you are masters now. Why should any problems make you suffer? Why should? You are contented within yourself. All these problems, useless absolutely, should not bother you. That means you are not yet come up to that level which we can call a master. I call you masters. You are like Zen masters. But see the Zen masters, how they are. Tao people, how they write, what they have to say. Boldly they will say everything, and they are so satisfied within themselves. They don't talk of small, petty nonsense. Not that you are not intelligent, you are all very intelligent people. And in that intelligence I find that if the attention goes to all nonsensical things, it is absolutely going to be detrimental. The another thing you have, must have noticed that so many people are now coming from India. Why? What is so great about India? Why don't they have people from here? What is the reason? The first reason is that parents neglect the education and discipline of children. Children must be disciplined. That's the job of the parents. Otherwise they would hang from some trees. But they are your children, you have to discipline them. They should know how to behave. They should know how to talk to people. A so-called freedom idea of America has ruined your country. First of all, children must be brought up in such a way that they are disciplined servants. They have proper sense of protocol. Otherwise, you will be creating just useless children. Thirdly, so much accent on money, money orientation. For children also here, as I have seen in the education, children are asked to clean the car, they will pay £5, $5. Then he does something, don't pay them. That's their work, that's their job, that's their responsibility. Otherwise, if you start doing like this, you will spoil your children. At a proper time, you can give them some presents or something. But don't start giving them money like this. Then money becomes important. I have seen many Sahaj Yogis who came to me and they said that we don't want to do graduation, Mother, we don't want to study, we want to become garbage cleaners. I said, why? Because you can get a lot of money in garbage cleaning. Can you believe that? So the whole attitude is towards getting money at any cost. No dignity, no understanding, nothing. So children are to be told of sublime ways, of nobler ways, of higher ways. You already have got realized children. But if you don't tell them, then I don't know what will happen. They'll become garbage cleaners. First and foremost for children is discipline and their education. You must pay all money, whatever is needed, all your attention to educate your children. Now with that, no education, what's happening is the children have no breeding. Either put them in some profession if they want. Put them in anything where they can learn something. That's the age when one has to learn. Not just leave them because it's freedom, let them have their own time. It's a wrong idea. That is how this country is ruined, I think. And then the family system also is nonsensical. I have bought this house, it's very interesting, but what I find that there's a huge big room for husband and wife. A small room and 2-3 bathrooms for it. I bought it because it was just for my own sake, it was all right. But from the very beginning they have idea that children will go away at the age of 18 years. Why should children leave you? If you have a proper house, even if you don't have a proper house, if you have all the love and convenience, they'll never leave you. Our India is difficult. We had Avdhoot, you must be knowing him, Mr. Pai's son. So Mrs. Pai was very much caught up on the left. Very serious, very innocent boy. He came to me and he said, Mother, if you leave your parents, whose child? If you leave your parents at the age of, say, 18 years, then will their bhoots leave you? They asked me a question. I said, it may not. Then why to leave parents? You know, parents are very useful. I said, how? He said, firstly, my father is there, so I will never take to smoking because he'll scold me. I'll not do wrong things, so it's better to have a father. So I said, really? Yes, he said, in a carriage, if there's nobody to manage the horse, horse will go wrong, he said. Very intelligent also, very deep, but see the innocence of his heart. He said, no, no, there's no use leaving the parents. Nice, they should be there to tell us. Otherwise, who will tell us? So, you see, this should be perpetuated in your children also to understand that somebody has to tell, somebody has to guide. Now, what has happened, I think, in the West is that people have advanced. Now, say, the central line is here. They came from a developing state and now they are overdeveloped. So now, to come to Sahaj Yoga, they have to come back. They have to come back, which is very difficult for developed people to come back. But for people who are black, say, people who are not so developed, they are very good because once they start developing, they can be sucked in. So very easy to get the black people to us. So I would say you all should work among black people. Skin is not something I think is so important. So these skin deep problems that you have should be completely given up. You'll find such beautiful, such nice people among. So you have to talk to them and you have to look after them. Now I can't do that myself, but you can do it as my children. Try to see the good points of all these people, of all the people. Even now, say, some people who go to India like Indians very much and they praise them. I said, what's so special about Indians? Mother, they will sleep on the ground but put the guest on the bed. It's fact. You don't put your guest on the ground, you see, in India. No, you don't do that. And that day, it's a correct thing. If the guests are there, they are given the first priority. It's the other way around in America. If the guests, you take them to some, say, restaurant, first thing you will say, we are sharing, you know, it shocks people in India. Sharing means, well, I mean, they are your guests. So the sense of guests, the sense of people who are not your family has to be developed. Then they will understand that there's something special about it. But you see, selfishness, this open, starkingly horrible selfishness is so much exhibited. So there should be some sort of a, we call them maryadas, must be the protocol. And let the people see you, how you behave. That is how Sahaj Yoga will spread. They'll see you in the society, they'll see you everywhere. I was told the governor of Nevada went to Bulgaria and there he saw some Sahaj Yogis in Bulgaria. He was so impressed by their behavior that he wanted to meet me, but just now I don't know if I'll have time or not, but he wanted to meet me. So our behavior should be such, should be very humble, sharing, caring, so that people are impressed by it. And there's no need to have any shyness about it. Some people think we are very weak. You are not. You have got the powers. You are not weak anymore, one thing. In the same way, you are very strong, and that's why you are very humble. Only strong people can be humble. People who are not strong always are aggressive. We have solved some problems in Sahaj Yoga, like morality and all that. Of course, I agree. But still, I think the attention is not so correct as it should be, absolutely pure. We worship Ganesha, and the power of Ganesha must show, because as I have told you, that innocence is not lost. It's only covered and it can be cleared out. The whole world, we can say, we have to save the whole world. My vision is too big, and you are my children, you are my hands. I cannot ask anybody else to do it. And that's why I have to tell you that you just be worried about the people who are around. Care for them. Show them love. And I'm sure they will understand that you are something really different from others. It's not difficult, because some of the value systems in America are so much convoluted, so much perverse, that if you just go against it, people will be amazed. How are they like this? You have capacity. What I'm saying, you have powers. You are just like diamonds. Diamonds can be seen anywhere. Only thing, you should chisel out yourself a little bit. Chiseling out is very important, and that's possible through your meditation, introspection. Simple things like that. What am I doing for Sahaja? What I'm working for Sahaja? All this has to be seen and has to be worked out with great love and understanding that our mother wants the whole world to be Sahaja. Whole world. It's not only few people here. But Los Angeles has this problem, I don't know why, since long. So I would request you to see those files. Now my suggestion is very practical, as we have done in India now. Forget about whatever has happened in the past. But in India what I did was I took one hall on my own in Dadar, one hall. And all the Sahaja Yogis, I said, you come there. You can have it twice. You can have it Saturday, Sunday. You can have some people for Saturday who are newcomers like that, who are not in there. And you can have Sunday for all the Sahaja Yogis. 2 days you must spare. And the first day you have to take into account that these people are not yet matured. So you have to mature them. Only thing that will really impress is you, the way you are. Nothing else. And also you should not spend too much time in talking too much or talking in this thing. But if they have any questions, you can answer at the most. But they will take to our tapes and things very deep. I agree, the tapes are very deep. But if they listen to it again and again, they'll understand. So many things are there for you to see and to tell them. Whatever impresses them, you have to talk to them. Now the time is coming that many false gurus will be completely exposed. I know that. But then you all have to come up. But what I feel, that Sahaja Yogis are like mushrooms. They get their realization, finished. Then they have nothing to do. How can that be? So what I'm trying to say, you must have complete faith in yourself. It's very important. I am a Sahaja Yogi. Have that faith. What have I done? Ask yourself a question. What do I have to do? So all your behavior, all your sweetness, all your kindness, everything will impress. Not only that, but negative forces won't act. If you try to be positive, negative forces will not act. They will have no effect on you. They will have complete protection for you, complete protection. And they look after you. So I have to make now a very, very request as a mother to all of you, that you have to be worthy of my children. Say, now I'm going to be 78 and still I'm working very hard. Since I've come to Los Angeles, I've been sick. What is the reason? I'm never sick. But I felt very weak, I couldn't walk. Why? Well, what has happened? Because you people are weak. You are my children. You are part and parcel of my body. You are not only that, but you are cells of my body. If you are weak, I'll become weak. So I request you again and again that you got such a great blessing which people don't get normally. Very difficult. They go to Himalaya, spend years together. And then they get the blessings. So now you got it so easily, just strengthen yourself. Tell yourself, be confident that I have to do this work. So as I was saying, we can have, what is the center?
Santa Monica.
Santa Monica. In Santa Monica, you can take 2 days. One day you can have it for the newcomers and one day for all the Sahyogis. And at least 25 Sahyogis must go to Santa Monica on the first day. And should be all of you next day. Because unless and until you do that way, it won't strengthen. We call it Sangha Shakti, is the collective power which you should have. And you see, if somebody has problems, if somebody is, is not understanding, is not going deep, is newcomer and all that. So let them come on Saturdays. You can answer them, you can explain to them, you can make them understand. And you'll be amazed that even things like this internet business, I'm very happy in a way, because all those who were useless have gone. It's the last judgment. So this is the best way. They have gone away. So now new people can come. But it's a very good thing that has happened, but still these people wanted. So we have written a very beautiful answer to it. And that will read it. So now you have to just now promise within yourself that you will attend Santa Monica or any one center that you have. It's a simple thing to understand that if you have to dig the well, you don't go on putting holes everywhere. But in one place only you make a big effort. And there is a center which everyone knows. They all come there and you meet. But you have to be extremely positive. Extremely positive. It's the new people. Now you can imagine in a place like called Benin. They were all Muslims. And 9,000 have become now Sahyogis. And just imagine. And Ivory Coast, the president is a Sahyogi. How could these black people achieve all that? And while with all of you with white skins, what are you doing? It's some sort of drawback. Power, I think, this getting white. All right, I expected because they are seekers. Best part is they are seekers. Black people are not seekers. They are not such seekers. But white people are seekers. But they are seeking into this nonsense, that nonsense, that nonsense. And now we have an article about this horrible gentleman, Mahishasura. Everything is exposed. And whatever I have said about him is there in that. I didn't tell them, but they have got it from other people. And now, you see, all his castle will fall down. Because that is truth. It has come in the newspaper. It's authentic. It's not like sending in the internet. But despite that, your faith is challenged. Oh, Bhopali, I nahi aaj. I nahi. It's very sad. Her father will get a heart attack, I tell you. All right. So can you read it out to them?
Yes.
Answer. You have seen everything. You have seen so many miraculous photographs. I mean, Param Chaitanya has never done that. Nobody has photographs of that kind of an imaginary. These artists must have sought to put it there. But you have seen so many, you have seen Ganesha standing behind it. I mean, such miraculous photographs you have seen, and still your faith is so weak. What else should it go? Param Chaitanya asked me, what should we do now? Kai samjhatas nahi?
Strong shraddha, drudha shraddha.
Buddhi kutna yenar? I have given a nice lecture on Devi Puja. Vasli Vinayat Kumar? You just see, that is shraddha rupena samstita. very big difference between just faith and Shraddha. So Shraddha to aise ki when you think of that person, the whole being becomes full, just like a garden. Asa zala paaje. Yata vastu yu Shraddha. Can you read it? Tum padh ke sunao, wo ek aur.
Copy.
Padho. And so many miracles have taken place. I mean, it's to be seen what miracles take place.
This is a response to the allegations which was published on the internet against Sahaja Yoga. There has been some recent material on the this is a response by Sahaja Yoga to these allegations. There has been some recent material on the internet which contains allegations made against Sahaja Yoga and its founder, Her Holiness Sri Mataji Nirmala Devi. All of these allegations are coming from a group of very few people who are supported by some false gurus or by some criminal organizations. It is such a bundle of falsehood that it is rather difficult to pay any attention to such nonsensical allegations. All kinds of people come into Sahaja Yoga because the doors of Sahaja Yoga are open to all. Some of these people were thrown out either because they were immoral or they were cheating other Sahaja Yogis. Sahaja Yoga is the absolute manifestation of divine reality and truth. To begin with, the greatest miracle is that there are thousands and thousands of miraculous photographs of Sri Mataji. Most of them were taken by very ordinary cameras and by amateurs. One photograph appeared in Brisbane in the sky as a painting of Raphael, which was a painting that Sri Mataji liked very much. In the actual painting,
this Raphael paints mostly the mother and child. And I was told there's an exhibition here of Raphael. I would like to go and see that.
In the actual painting, there was a halo at the back of the Holy Mother. But in the sky, it was on top of the Mother. In England, they were singing the song, "Sitting in the Heart of the Universe." And all around her appeared many hearts drawn in lines exactly as one would find in a medical text. Very early on in Switzerland, they saw clouds clustering into a very clear image of Sri Mataji, absolutely perfect. There are deities that appeared in full form behind her and angels that are seen very clearly. We all felt the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost on our fingertips. Many Muslims also felt it. This has been described in the Holy Quran that at the time of resurrection, your hands will speak. And after tallying with Sri Mataji's knowledge and her description of relationships between vibrations and chakras, we were surprised how it was the perfect knowledge of our subtle system. So many countries have given awards to Mother. In America, Sahaja Yoga is accepted as a religion, and you can be prosecuted for referring to it as a cult. Sri Mataji's achievements are recorded in the Congressional Archives, and highly respected doctors, scientists, professionals have recognized her. Leaders of this country, from mayors and governors to presidential candidates, have sent felicitations to her. In America, she has been honored in major cities by dedicating a day in her name as Sri Mataji Nirmala Devi Day. Her deep knowledge has stunned people, and she has been awarded advanced degrees of PhD from leading world universities. fabulous revelations of her divine personality are captured on film in thousands of miracle photographs which manifest the greatest forms of deities and divinity. How unfortunately stupid they were not to understand the great miracles that the divine created to convince human beings so that they may not go astray. But this is Kali Yuga, and they fail to recognize the truth despite all these revelations. We discovered that one of these few culprits used to sleep with a maidservant in the ashram, even though he was married and was caught. And then he was caught and was thrown out of the ashram. One of them had a car accident with a lady, but blamed another Sahajyogi for it. When the lady recognized his picture in a group photograph, the police arrested him. We don't know what the police did to him, but as a result, he turned against Sahajyoga. Another one brought money to be given to Sahajyoga, but since Srimadiji never takes money from individuals like that, she refused the money. This was black money from a woman who had died. We didn't inform the police about this because we would not take black money. He got frightened and turned against Sahajyoga. Another one had built a house which he wanted Srimadaji to buy. She didn't buy it because it was of no use to Sahajyoga, and so he turned against Sahajyoga and became bankrupt. He was an idle, lazy lump and a drug user, and thought himself to be the lord of the whole world. Very quarrelsome, arrogant, and a stupid fellow. We are relieved that he has left Sahajyoga. They are such nonsensical people because they talk about allegations of tax evasion by Sri Mataji. Sri Mataji is a registered non-resident Indian and does not need to pay any tax on casual income. These people are illiterate and don't know tax laws. In these allegations, they also spoke about her husband, who is recognized by the British government for his immaculate and extremely honest work and was bestowed the title of KCMG. He is such a well-regarded personality that these people who are trying to throw dirt on his character cannot even get jobs as peons in his office. Her brother was also a great soul. He never took advantage of Sahajyoga and has built a very great academy of music. These people are not even equal to touch the dust of his feet. They are such low-level people. They are cowards to write such trash on the internet. There is not even the slightest truth in these statements, only blatant lies. These allegations on the internet are such cowardly acts. If they claim allegations against her or Sahajyoga, then why don't they come to the court of law? This theory that Rajneesh has influenced Sri Mataji is another myth. Can Rajneesh or any of his disciples give realization to people? You can answer this yourself. To make allegations that Sri Mataji makes a lot of money through Sahajyoga is absurd. The money for the work of Sahajyoga was collected during the first few years by only 4 leaders. They gulped all the money for their advantage without showing any accounts. So the senior members of Sahajyoga asked permission of Sri Mataji to collect the money in her name and put it in the bank. Still, Sri Mataji for 20 years has spent all her money for travel, halls, activities of Sahajyoga. People only paid for their tour in India, for the purchase of Shuddhi camps. She spent her own 400,000 sterling pounds, which is recorded, and only 250,000 pounds were given by Sahajyogis. Approximately 100 people stayed absolutely free at the house for more than 4 years. Since the house was sold for only 400,000 pounds, all that money belonged to Sri Mataji. By now, we really felt ashamed that why should mother spend all this money herself when she has given us health, wealth, balance, peace and joy through self-realization. Apart from that, she has given us divine knowledge, which is invaluable. And we felt that it would be parasitic to make her spend all this money because she would not take any money from any individual. She has cured many rich people. and they were all trying to give her money, but she would not accept any. So we thought that as a practice, we should give some money to our mother who has worked so hard, sacrificing her life, giving so much love and compassion. A small amount was fixed to give as Guru Dakshina, as was a practice for all the true gurus of the world. Sri Mataji has not gained financially at all through Sahaj Yoga, and even though it is absolutely legal to take or give money, it is certainly not a sin in giving and taking money from anyone. Do these people know how many projects Sri Mataji has opened in Italy, in India, Italy, England, America, Australia, and other parts of the world for noble and social causes? There are over 35 projects that she has single-handedly funded, which you can see on our website at www.sahajyoga.org. The greatest lie is that Sri Mataji doesn't love children. She has tremendous compassion for children, and the tapes that are quoted are bogus. The tape from Canberra is a complete manipulation of the truth, since there was no child crying in the public program. Some lines are correct, but all falsehood is built on that. It's true that Sri Mataji has great concern for realized children. We have many children in Sahaj Yoga who have received scholarships, awards and recognitions in schools, in many schools around the world. They are outstanding in their education and their moral character, and are extremely loving, dynamic and sweet children. The Western promiscuity and immorality have not entered into their minds. Sri Mataji has gone all out to save the children from drugs, child abuse, alcoholism, gangs, etc. The children in Sahaj Yoga are so outstanding, well-behaved and well-educated. These people are condemning Sahaj Yoga, while she has saved so many seekers and transformed the lives of hundreds of thousands of people in the world of turmoil. There are some who have also cheated in Sahaj Yoga as leaders. All these despicable people have been thrown out of Sahaj Yoga. And some of these people have now turned against Sahaj Yoga because we don't want them back. Whatever has been mentioned in these allegations about Sahaj Yoga marriages is absolutely opposite of what really happens. First, the applicants from all over the world fill out and submit their application forms referencing their height, weight, education, income, family background, and other important information. The couples are then chosen based on divine vibrations. These couples then spend a few days meeting each other and getting to know each other in a completely moral manner. Only if they agree, they are then married in a collective wedding ceremony. There are over 200 marriages per year performed in Sahaj Yoga from all over the world, and the success rate of these marriages is about 99%. With just 1% of the marriages that are voided. Since they are not registered until 6 months to a year after the ceremony, so they have sufficient time to decide. Divorce is allowed in Sahaj Yoga, since both the parties are adult and have full freedom to make their own decisions. We don't know of any system among the world religions, especially in the West, where there is a 99% success rate in marriage. Sahaj Yoga glorifies the marriage institution, and we believe that morality can be naturally restored through proper Sahaj Yoga marriages. The cost of marriages in Sahaj Yoga is only about $100, which includes all the ornaments, presents, meals, etc. Sahaj Yoga culture and its system of marriages have completely abolished the dowry system, which we believe is one of the greatest reforms of the Indian social system. The calculation of money that they have made is absurd. All the money that is collected in Sahaj Yoga by the organization is recorded with proper accounts and is spent for so many social, charitable, and noble works. All this money is deposited in respectable banks and institutions. There is not even a single cent that is deposited in a Swiss bank or a Monte Carlo type of organization, as has been alleged in these accusations. There is a finance committee in every country which takes care of these funds and manages expenses from these funds. In addition, all the casual income of Sri Mataji is recorded by one committee, which spends funds from it appropriately on various noble and social projects worldwide to help helpless people. For the seminar collections, all of these accounts were created in the name of Sri Mataji because we had so many bad leaders in the past that became corrupted with money, although Sri Mataji trusted them. All the funds collected in Sahaj Yoga are public knowledge. The money contributed by Sahaj Yogis is kept in the name of Sahaj Yoga, and only by Sri Mataji's consent is it spent for different expenses and projects. Since 1972, over 36 projects such as land development, buildings, hospitals, schools, ashrams, institutes for social benefit, etc., have been created from these funds only. Progressively, many of these projects have been and are under, progressively, many of these projects have been and are being transferred over to the Sahaj Yoga Charitable Organization. Sri Mataji comes from a royal family, and her husband comes from a family of landlords. The nobility of her vision was so great that in the early years of Sahaj Yoga, she sold her own jewelry to sponsor programs of Sahaj Yoga. Apart from that, her husband has been working in London for 16 years and had a salary of over 5,000 sterling pounds after taxes in those days, in addition to all facilities. Additionally, they had very high gains from sale of houses in London. The point is that Sri Mataji is so independently well off that she didn't need to start Sahaj Yoga to make money. In the early days of Sahaj Yoga, she paid from her own money even the air tickets for so many new people who came to Sahaj Yoga to travel and experience spiritual places in India. Sri Mataji has made us aware that all the religions are from the same principle and are to be respected by all of us. She has formed a global religion, which is the innate pure religion, by giving us self-realization. But so-called religions want to stay separate so that they can fight in the name of religion and God. From her teaching, many rituals, false ideas about religion have been corrected. We respect all the incarnations, prophets, and the realized souls of the past. These can be seen in the Sahaj Yoga publications such as Bible Enlightened, Islam Enlightened, and Gita Enlightened, can also be verified from the thousands of her speeches. There has never been a charge at the door for Sahaj Yoga meditation. We don't get any charitable funding from any government agencies for doing our programs. How does one expect to have all these programs to be handled without money? Sahaj Yogis contribute freely whenever money is needed for projects, and that is how it is done. No one in Sahaj Yoga has ever been forced or condemned for not giving money. For the last 30 years, Sri Mataji has been working relentlessly, and there have been no claims against Sahaj Yoga of any kind. At a personal level, she has sacrificed her financial and family life enormously. These people should be ashamed of themselves to attack such a pure and noble personality who is full of love and compassion. She has given us the lifelong gift of self-realization, and we give her something in return as a token of our love. There is nothing wrong in that. At the puja seminars, our organization offers her a gift from all of us, but she in return gives gifts to everyone in the seminar, sometimes thousands of people at a time. Sri Mataji is a very pure personality, like her name Nirmala, which means pure, and is extremely detached about money. there are so many false gurus and false teachers who have minted money and are still minting money. Why don't these people write about them? An idle mind is a devil's workshop. Sri Mataji has benefited thousands and thousands of us with the blessings of Srimadji, while these few people have condemned Sahaj Yoga by their own malicious propaganda. In a way, this is good, because as per Her Holiness Sri Mataji, this is the last judgment, and the people who follow this kind of falsehood will also miss this opportune time. Many renowned scientists, professors, artists, prime ministers, presidents, home ministers, etc., have fully accepted Sahaj Yoga because this is a pure science which cannot be challenged. There are so many signs in thousands of miracle photographs taken by Sahaj Yogis verifying the existence of verifying the existence of divinity in this era. There are scientists in many countries who have verified scientifically that Sri Mataji is the source of cosmic energy. And now many of them are writing books and theses on this. We as Sahaj Yogis have full faith that Sri Mataji is the promised mother and the Holy Spirit which Christ has declared. These kinds of evil-spirited people who have always tortured great incarnations, Sufis and saints. Also, this was the kind of people who crucified Christ. As members of this wonderful organization, we have been asking Sri Mataji's permission for the last 1 year to write a response against these false accusations. But she has been so compassionate, even towards these evil-minded people. Now is the first time that she has allowed us to write such a response because of the pressure from so many Sahaj Yogis worldwide to do so. Self-realization is the actualization of baptism. And when the seeker gets connected to this all-pervading divine power called Ruh or Param Chaitanya, and Einstein has described it as the torsion area. As a result of self-realization, a seeker becomes balanced, peaceful, and joyous. All of the six enemies of human life, like lust, greed, anger, attachment, jealousy, and false pride, disappear. One becomes like a drop in the ocean of compassion and love. Such a transformation, which is described and predicted, takes place, which is very much needed in the sinking world of turmoil today. We don't know how to thank Sri Mataji for this free gift. Sri Mataji is a perfect ideal to follow, with so many worldwide achievements that her unfathomable knowledge and yet so much humility. Her motherly love and compassion is ever present even in the midst of thousands of people whose names and problems she remembers very well individually in minute details as she receives a flower with her loving smile that warms every heart and fills it with love. The work of Sahaj Yoga is so tremendous that it cannot be described in this small letter. So please visit our website at www.sahajyoga.org for more details. For more details of her work and her relentless work. This is the first of many articles that we want to publish to bring forth the real facts about Sahaj Yoga and about Her Holiness Sri Mataji Nirmala Devi. Even though we know most of these people who are writing these false articles against Sahaj Yoga and their motives behind it, Sri Mataji has asked us not to mention their names, as she feels that once they also called her mother. Thank you.
Very powerful. But still there are people, you see, who are weak, I think very weak people, and do not want to become real Sahajyogis. There are. And you must locate them, find out, apart from the new ones. But if they are no good, it's better to give them up, you see. Give them up, because they are so immoral, they do such horrible things. And they cheat, even me cheat you people. Like in India, they purchased one plot of land, saying that we are making Nirmal Nagari. I never knew anything about it, nothing. They never consulted me. The fellow who cheated used to come up and sit in the gallery and told, I have asked mother, she said yes, everything. Such a cheat he was. And he wanted to make a big money out of it. But it so happened, you know, I was quite surprised how they have done it, that a letter came from the government saying that this land, you cannot build anything because it is, it has floods. I said, very good, that's the best way. Now, so then these people, I said, now why did you buy without asking? It was a wrong thing, they took money from everyone. And I mean, I don't know, they were up to something. But luckily the chartered accountant who was there, Agarwal, he was a very nice man. And he came and told me, mother, see this much money they have taken from this person, this person, this person. They removed their own money. They were so frightened, now I'll do something. They removed their money. I said, keep it now and we will sell this land. Can you imagine that that land was not to be sold, was not allowed to be sold, but somehow this particular land was allowed. And we made profit of, I think, 16 lakhs of rupees on that. And everybody got back their money, everything they got back. And with what we got, 16 lakhs we used for buying a land in Delhi. Because so far I've been buying all land myself. Ashram, I'm making this, all that. So now, thank God, they were happy they could buy one piece of land, which is quite good in Delhi, which they're working out. And everyone who purchased the land has got the money back. That's most satisfying. Because then I thought, if I don't get the money, I'll pay myself. But they all got back their money, I'm very happy about it. And they were so anxious that they should go and beat this man. I said, forget it, give me 1 year. If it works out, we shouldn't take anything. It worked out. So those who try to cheat me also are in trouble. See, some or other, I don't do anything, but they just get into trouble, I don't know. Must be the deities try to trouble them. So best thing is to have a very clean heart about such. That's the best way, because nobody gains anything out of it. If there's anything to be gained, it's the human beings, so nothing else is important. All right. So thank you very much for everything. Now, whatever I have said, it's not only for Los Angeles, for all the Americans, for all the world, but especially for Los Angeles, I found out a solution like that. And next time when I come, I would like to see many more Sahajyogis. We'll have a program, and then you should take down their names, their addresses, get after them, and it will work out. I'm sure we'll grow very much here. And nothing to worry that it's very superficial or it's more the cinema and all that. Nothing to do. It will definitely work out, I'm sure. But you must have that intent and intense feeling of doing it. It will work out. Thank you. Yala. Photo. Hello. Ah, I must tell you about Mr. Bush. I don't know how, but this Mr. Bush has been very much impressed by Kalin, you know, Kalin, who is from Romania. And he, for the last 5 of my birthdays, he has been sending me best wishes. He's a nice man, I must say, vibration-wise, very good. And, I saw this another fellow was, he was very cunning, I must say. Not only that, but also very shrewd type of a man. And I thought that he cannot win. But you see, this one of the qualities of the goddess is that said that Aya Devi Sarabhuteshu Bhranti Rupena Samstita. Means she creates confusion. And I have explained in my last puja why she creates a confusion. So you see the confusion that's going on. And Rajesh Shah, who is an expert on Devi Mahatmyam, he said that, Mother, now are you creating confusion there? I said, you have a look, see, let us see what.
So while he was watching the election as it was happening, the Florida state was given to Gore in the beginning. Huh. So Shumaji gave it a bandhan. Literally 2 minutes later, they said, it's undecided.
So, this Bhranti is working very well here. And I think, you see, this country is to be saved. And he wrote a very nice letter to me also. He was very sweet. He's a nice man, you know. He's very, I should say, very princely type. He's not cheap like this man. He's very cheap. He's going so far with all kinds of tricks and things. Then the other day I saw him laughing, his wife laughing. I was quite surprised. Then I was told that people criticize that you don't laugh, that's why he was laughing. Kai level. With Bush we can do a lot, I'm sure.
Sri Mataji, on behalf of all of the yogis in Los Angeles, I'd just like to say that we understand very well that your arrival here and your taking up residence on the west coast of America is not a casual thing, that it's very purposeful, and that you have a great vision for America and the growth of Sahaj Yoga, not only in Los Angeles, but in this whole country, and that you're here to sort us out and to show to us all of the weaknesses and the lackings of both our society and our own growth. And I would just like to make a commitment on behalf of all of us that we will do everything that we can and in our power to become your hands, to fulfill your vision and your dreams for us as seekers and as yogis, to fulfill and reach our purpose and your vision of us. We will make every effort to reach the people of this place and to show them the beauty and vastness of your vision and to bring them to your feet, Sri Mataji. Please give us your blessings and your attention so that we can go forth and carry your vision to the people and fulfill it in the future. Thank you so much, Sri Mataji, for coming to Los Angeles and to America. And we hope that the next time you come, that you'll be happy and you'll find us worthy of your attention.
You are already worthy. All right, thank you very much. Thank you. May God bless you. चलिए फिर